Welcome to Urban Health. Today, we're going to be training with Molly Reid, the nutritionist. She's going to answer a few questions for us concerning nutrition. We're also going to be doing a routine that you guys can do at home or on the road if you're traveling. And we're going to get into that as she's warming up. Right now, she's going to do a warm-up that's going to include her upper and lower half. Compound movement is a pretty good way to warm up most of the time. You can even warm up with something simple as a free squat without the kettlebell. Kettlebell, you can use a jug of water. You can use anything that gives you about 10 to 20 pounds of weight to get you going. You want to sit straight on those hips. Keep that back straight. Try your best not to go past parallel. So what you're going to do now is you're going to lay flat. You're going to hold those kettlebells up just like this, and you're going to do your leg raise. Again, you can do this exercise, keep those arms nice and straight. You can hold water in your hand, two jugs of water, gallons. This is a, call this a leg raise press. After she finishes her leg raise, she's gonna go into a chest press with these. These are really good for your lower abs, which is the hardest ones to develop because they're so flat and long, okay? And now do a regular bench press, up and push up, two. Good. Exhale. Three. Good. Just want to talk about a lot of people who are going to nutritionists, getting diets from them, and you know they put them on a whole bunch of pills and you know all pills that they don't know anything about. Just want to give a little insight on that and how you feel about that.
Well, no nutritional supplements are monitored at all by the FDA.
Okay.
So you have to be really careful when you're getting a supplement because you don't know if what they're claiming is true. You also want to be really careful that the reason you got the supplement is within the first three ingredients, because all of them are listed in the amount of what's in. So if you're buying a supplement for chromium and chromium's not in the first three ingredients, there's not enough in there to make a difference.
Gotcha. Okay, break's over, we're going back to work now. same exact thing. Now we're gonna do this, and then after this set, you're kicking the push-up. We're gonna mix this up. So you're gonna do one leg raise and then one press. So you're gonna alternate back and forth on this one, okay? Again, this is something you can do at home, your hotel room. There you go, one. By doing this, the lower abs, well, all six of them actually are staying under stress the whole time because the legs are never touching the floor. At the same time, she's getting that upper body pushing a little bit. I'm just gonna go for 10 of these. A big fan of push-ups for women. It's a hard exercise for most women, so when I see a woman that can do it, it's pretty good. You can go a little bit wider on your hands too. So it's break time again. Ready? Next question I want to talk about is I hear a lot of people saying, well, they don't like eating after 6 o'clock p.m. Catch your breath for a minute, then you can answer that one. I hear a lot of people saying, well, I can't eat after 6 or I can't eat after 7. And I just wanted to know, you know, how you felt about that.
The way they say you should eat is king's breakfast, prince's lunch, pauper's dinner. So
gotcha.
You should be doing the majority of your eating earlier in the day and then light eating at night.
Gotcha.
But you shouldn't go to bed starving.
Right, right.
So if you're hungry at night, the best way to go is a high water content fruit.
Gotcha.
Pear, apple, melon.
And that would hold them over until the morning most of the time. Okay. We're going into burpee press. So normally, when you do a burpee, you will kick them out, jump back, jump. Instead of jumping, we're gonna have Molly go into a press at the top, okay? And you can do these, if you have dumbbells at home, you can do these with your dumbbells. Real simple, you don't need a machine for these. Just remember when you're kicking them out, you wanna squeeze those abs, keep them contract on the way up, you wanna squeeze again. As you're pressing up, you wanna exhale. So now she's gonna go right into her bicep curl. Yep, she's gonna contract on the way up, unfold those arms, two, good, three, she's exhaling on the way up, four, contracting those abs, keeping them tight. Again, these are all things that you can do at home. If you can't make it to the gym, if you get home at strange hours and you don't wanna go back out, this is where you wanna go. If you can't find a babysitter for your little one, you can do this, you can do these, this routine at home. On a Russian twist, use the same dumbbell that you use to press with to go up to about 30, 15 on each side. And you want to, at the same time, you want to keep those abs nice and tight while you're twisting. These are good for your abs as well as your obliques.